In this video, I will walk you through getting started with ComponentOne FlexGrid for WPF and Silverlight. I will show you how to populate the FlexGrid control with some data, and we'll format some columns in code and XAML. First, you should add the control to your application and set its name property so that you can access it in your code behind. Here, I've named the control C1 FlexGrid 1. Once you have added the FlexGrid to your application, you will normally populate it using the ItemSource property. The ItemSource property expects an object that implements the IEnumerable interface, such as a list, an observable collection, or a collection view. For example, here I have created a list of type product, which is my custom business object. To populate the FlexGrid, I will set its ItemSource property to my list. And that's all I need to do. At runtime, the FlexGrid scans the data source and automatically generates columns for each public property on the business object. The grid also automatically adjusts the width of each column based on its data type. Next, you may want to change the width of a column or set some other properties for a specific column. So let me show you how to do that in code. For example, to change the width of the discontinued column, I can access the column through the controls columns collection and set its width property. You can access any column by index or by its name. So here, I've increased the discontinued column width to 100 pixels. Another thing you can do is format a column by setting its format property. The C1 FlexGrid control supports standard .NET format strings. Here, I'm formatting the price column to display as currency with two places past the decimal by simply using the string C2. It's that easy to adjust the size of a column and apply some basic formatting. You'll notice some features of the grid are enabled by default, such as column dragging and sorting. And the selection mode is set to a single cell range. You can very easily configure these features by setting properties on the FlexGrid control. You'll find that many features can be enabled or disabled by just setting a single property. For instance, I will disable column dragging, enable row resizing, and I'll change the selection mode to multiple rows by just setting a few properties. The last thing I will walk through in this video is how to explicitly define your columns in XAML. This can be more desirable for MVVM scenarios, as you can apply your bindings and converters in XAML without having to write any code. You may disable the automatic column generation by setting the auto-generate columns property to false. Then, you may define your columns in the columns collection. You can use the columns collection editor or just type out the XAML. The C1 FlexGrid control supports just one type of column. Here, I'm binding my three columns to the name, price, and discontinued properties from my data object. Binding is the only property you must set on each column, but here I'm also setting the width and format properties. Whether you work mostly in code or in XAML is up to you. Everything can be done in both, but you'll find during your WPF or Silverlight development that some things are better done in code and others best done in XAML. Thanks for watching this Getting Started video on ComponentOne FlexGrid. For more resources, such as how-to articles, documentation, and samples, visit the ComponentOne community at our.componentone.com.